been searching for that thing to get them higher. You can't catch my drip, can't catch my wave. You'll burn out if you jump into the fire. Can you feel it rushing through your veins? Though you may get all that you desire, no ceiling with that never be the same. You'll burn out if you jump into the fire. Can you feel it rushing through your, right through your veins? Though you may get all that you desire, no ceiling with that never be the same. You'll burn out if you jump into the fire.
He originally opened in 1995 as Jacksonville Municipal Stadium when this franchise entered the NFL. We welcome you to Jacksonville and TIAA Bank Field. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Arizona Cardinals and the Jacksonville Jaguars. First down, Wheatley, and this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30.
28, the ball carrier.
All right, Brandon, I know we're in the early going here, but those kind of runs, they're going to open up a world of opportunities for this offense going forward.
Now with the play clock about to expire, we get a whistle and a timeout. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Ball on the 30, they'll come up with a 2nd and 5. To throw. Whitfield. And he'll let this one go deep for Chark. And nearly an interception here on their opening drive. But instead, 3rd down.
I like the fact that he took the shot deep downfield. Even if you don't get the catch, maybe you get a defensive penalty and pick up the yardage that way.
Third play here, this opening drive, as they're up against a 3rd and 5. Off play action, Whitfield. Open man is Westbrook, complete. Give him 22 there on the 3rd down conversion.
And a key number on that play, 3. Third play of the drive, 3rd down. Spectacular catch, turns into a 1st down.
1st down saves him from a 3 and out. So into Cardinal territory now. It's 1st and 10 at the 48-yard line. Now the first carry for Dalvin Cook. And this time he's able to take it down to the 42. He'll get a nice chunk there on the 1st down run, and it's 2nd and 4.
A 6-yard pickup brings up 2nd and 4 at the 42-yard line.
Looking to throw on 2nd down. Whitfield. And this one into the hands of DJ Chark. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. And those linemen, of course, can't be more than a yard downfield when a pass is thrown, and they might have been able to call that on a couple of guys there.
I'm not set down with my account. He said I got good news.
to throw on second down. Whitfield. That is caught by Josh Oliver, the former San Jose State Spartan. A gain there of 21 yards.
I do believe we'll see a little bit more of this as this game progresses, because when you can have that type of a gain in the middle of the defense, it hurts them in so many ways, because most teams like to be strong down the middle. And if you can sting them there, that opened things up for you on the outside as well. But
that's where he, their big tight end, is so good, that middle third, the seam routes, the end routes. Yeah, you're right. Probably see more of that.
Yeah, it takes a lot of courage and fortitude to go in the middle as well, and he's got it.
They'll contain him to just four. Second down. 4 yards on that last completion, so that sets up second and six. And that'll be incomplete. We took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on third down.
I used to have a coach just tell us all the time, those scouting reports aren't just to use up paper, guys. Well, nowadays, you know, we're watching a computer screen, right? They scouted this team very well. Know that they like to use the running backs in the passing game. They covered that play successfully.
The open man is Shark. It's complete. And he's down inside the five at the four before he's out of bounds. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. First and goal, a good chance for our first touchdown of the new season. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he's maybe going to get this back to the four, but that's about all.
Jalen Thompson.
No gain on the play that time, but it sets up second and goal.
Leads to second and goal at the Cardinals' four-yard line.
Line of scrimmage, again the four-yard line, second and goal. Back to the ground, this time Cook. And he'll be stopped about a yard shy of the goal line after a pickup of about three.
Short of the goal line.
Driven it down the field nicely here on the opening drive, but now it's put up or shut up.
No doubt about it, because to make that type of a drive and ultimately kick a field goal would feel very disappointing. But I'm just wondering, is the head coach thinking, is this four down territory? Might he go for it?
Big play coming here. It's third and goal. They'll try to run this one in. And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Jacksonville. Taking it in from a yard out. And the Jaguars drive right down the field and score on the opening drive. And this is up and good. The score now 7-0 Jaguars.
Jaguars 7, Cardinals nothing.
And Lambeau now after the touchdown. He'll kick this one away.
Fair catch made at the 25-yard line. The Cardinals take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
And now the Jags going to signal for another timeout. And that's their second charge timeout here in this first quarter. They're down to one remaining. Murray and the Cardinals with a first and 10 at their 25-yard line. He's got this almost to the 40 before going out. First play of the drive going for 14 and also going for a first down.
Arizona.
Absolutely love the run right there. This guy's known for his quickness but also for his speed, and he's able to get to the second level almost before you blink if you give him any type of blocking. Always talk about slot receivers, and they're usually known as quicker than fast. In this case, we've got a guy who's quick and fast, and he used it to great advantage.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. From the gun, Murray. And the Jags get to him as down he goes. Raekwon McMillan. The blitz works to perfection as he gets in there to dump him for a loss of 8. They get 2 yards back, but they're going to need a lot more than that here on third down.
He's tackled at the 32-yard line. It's a gain of 2 yards, and it's third down.
Murray with a third and long, flushed out right. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
That was an interesting look there, because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them. And I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete. That is how you flip field position. That's an absolute bomb of a punt. Downs it inside the 5-yard line. Absolutely ideal.
And from that position, you're hoping to get it down inside the 15, inside the 5. Superb. And they'll come out with a 3 tight end look on the first play of the drive. They start the drive with Cook. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
And that's frustrating for a defense, because they've got them pinned down deep. And on the first play, they give up a run that keeps an offense on schedule.
Yeah, because 3 to 4 yards, that's all you're looking for right there, right?
That's absolutely perfect, really, as a play call. You get 3 to 4 yards on first down, that's what they talk about to us all the time, about being ahead of the chains or on target, ahead of schedule. They were after that run.
The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. Now Doug Marrone, with a play clock almost out, says, let's take a timeout. And my goodness, they're now out of timeouts here in this first quarter. Here's a 2nd and 7 now from their own 7. Looking to throw. Whitfield. He goes full extension, and he's got it. A first down there on a pickup of 25.
There's simply no sense in wasting a great catch like that on a short gain. Get downfield like he just did there and use it up that way.
No dink and dunk. After 1, 7-0 on EA Sports.
Jaguars 7, Cardinals nothing.
So they'll come up 1st and 10 now from the 33. They're throwing to start the drive, but that went incomplete.
I think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really. Second and 10 from the 33-yard line. Off the play fake. Whitfield. And he'll let this one go deep for Chark. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's 3rd down.
Thus far, they have been able to move the line of scrimmage very well in the running game. Almost felt like they said in the huddle, can you guys pass protect? Let's take a big shot downfield. Didn't get it on that one, but they may come back to it again.
So now 3rd and 10, a big play to start the drive, but nothing since. Off play action, Whitfield. And he's got his tight end, Oliver. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. A Jacksonville first down on a pickup of 17. 2 first downs have him up near midfield now on 1st and 10. From the gun, Whitfield. Oliver, the tight end, making the catch. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. 13 yards as they've got the connection working. His second catch in a row, first down. So into Cardinal territory now. It's first and 10 at the 37-yard line. Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. Laviska Shenault, the intended target. And that'll bring up second down. After the incomplete pass here now is second and 10. To throw again. Whitfield setting up the screen for Cook. And this one's going to go the wrong way. Losing yardage back at the 42. That'll wind up going for a loss of four. And it's going to be third down and a ways to go here. Third and 14. Operating from the gun. Whitfield. And he'll let this one go deep for Chark. And that is incomplete.
Sure, that pass was incomplete as they made an attempt to get a big one downfield. But that's okay because the second part of that is if you don't get the completion, at least you've told the defense you're trying to stretch them out a little bit and they may have to change accordingly.
The Cardinals take over first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. They were forced to punt on their initial drive of the new season. Now they're ready to go as they begin again with a first and 10. Out of the gun, here's Murray. Oh, a ball batted in the air, and now it's intercepted. Picked off at the 12, and fantastic field position has them just outside the 10 at the 11-yard line in the red zone. Now a first and 10 at the 11. On the carry, it's Cook. And he will get this into the end zone for a Jaguar touchdown. Taking it in from 11 yards out. And the Jaguars are able to widen their lead. Solid blocking up front from the guys on the offensive line allowed him to get in for the touchdown.
Yeah, some might say that the guys on the offensive line were in concert. I used to have a coach who called it marrying up, meaning when you get on a guy, you just stay right there. Each guy has his own assignment that allowed the runner to make the big move towards the end zone.
And that'll be a little too hot to handle as it will skip through the end zone for a touchback here. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And they're in an early hole. The first drive, they threw the interception. That led to a touchdown, so decent-sized deficit. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off near the 44.
So that's back-to-back drives where they're throwing an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Throwing to start the drive. Whitfield, nowhere to turn here, and he's gonna go down. Back at about the 37-yard line. So second and long, and gotta be careful not to fall out of field goal range. That one complete, he finds Sharp. And all the way inside the 15 before they drop it. A first down there on a pickup of 25.
First and 10 at the 13-yard line.
From the 13 now, they work on first and 10. Back to throw. Whitfield. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
Incomplete.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Cook. And power running here down to the 6-yard line. They get seven out of that, so they're left with a third and three.
But this play sequence was really kind of called in reverse. Incomplete pass on first and 10. Nice run on second and 10 when probably everyone was expecting them to throw the football. Now, if you're the defense, what are they going to do on third down? You're a little off balance.
And he won't have the touchdown, but he will have the first down as he's tackled at the two. Give him a gain of four, able to convert, and that sets up first and goal now. They'll run for it with Cook, and this will result in him losing yardage. Back to the three. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
And that's what I'd like to see out of this defense, a little fire, a little toughness. It hasn't been the best first half for them. They did do a nice job there, forcing a loss on that play.
And they'll be driven back here, losing yardage to the nine. They call that a loss of 6 yards. And it's third down now. Two minutes to play, first half, it's 14 to nothing. Now they'd really like to make the short field pay off. We'll see if they can, but this is third and goal. Looking to throw, Whitfield. He gets this one into the hands of Dalvin Cook. And this play doesn't go anywhere. Backwards, losing yardage to the 11.
That's a nice clip and save sequence there defensively because they did everything as they would have wanted to. They forced a third down, blanketed the field with coverage, nowhere to go with the football, forced a dump off to the back, and even then they closed quickly and got him down behind the line of scrimmage. You name it, they did it well in that last sequence.
Now after the main field goal, back out Lambeau to kick this one off. On the return, Andy Isabella. And able to get this across the 20, but not much further as he's dropped at the 23-yard line.
Take over first and 10 at their own 23-yard line.
Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And we don't want to call this desperation time, especially in the second quarter, but you're down.
You don't want to.
No, but let me finish.
Okay, my bad.
You're down 3 scores already. You've done nothing offensively, nothing on the scoreboard. That's not a good combination.
I think you
now
just
you
called
can go.
I think you just called a desperation time.
I think you did.
But let's face it, you mentioned this to me in a break earlier in the game. The energy level hasn't been there right from the start. We've noticed that. They've got to find a way to get on their toes and start punching instead of retreating, to use a boxing analogy.
The throw down the field, caught by his running back. The Cardinals going to use the first of their timeouts, as he'll get a chance to talk it over after picking up the first down. So quickly all the way up at the 40-yard line.
First down.
To throw is Murray. Buying time to his left. Oh, they've intercepted Murray for the third time. Picked off near the 42. There he goes, right side, and they will score. It's a Jacksonville touchdown. Now the Cards going to call another timeout, their second, as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. So that's now 3 first-half interceptions, and that last one even costlier as it's returned for 6 points. So as a quarterback, how do you regain your focus?
Well, QB 101 says you never show them that you're sweating. Still act like you're the guy, that you've thrown 6 touchdown passes, not 3 interceptions. But he's human. He's got to face up to his teammates. He's got to own up to that. See if he can brace up and also not look over his shoulder and see his backup starting to warm up. It's going to be a tough one for him.
Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You can never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity.
First down, Cardinals.
Murray now on first down. Dancing to his left. And that is intercepted. Or was it? Wait, they'll say no. No interception. He did not keep the feet in bounds, apparently. So that's just going to be an incompletion. Line of scrimmage, again, the 37 as they line up second and 10. Throwing again, Murray. Caught left side, Hopkins. And he'll go out near midfield at the 49. 12 yards there and a first down.
And a Cardinal first down.
First down, Murray. Escaping the pressure right. He's going to take off with it. Give him a couple on the scramble. It's second down.
They brought the blitz that time, and I thought they were going to get to him, but instead, he flipped it on its ear and ended up picking up positive yardage.
I thought he was dead to rights, but you are exactly correct, sir. Able to turn that into a positive gain. Here's Murray from midfield. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
This defense has been very disruptive early on as they force another one to go awry.
Seems to be the front and the back end. Pass rush, they've been able to get home, and they're taking the ball away in coverage as well.
I love how you put it together. The front and back working in sync, only way to play good defense.
So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves them staring up here at a third and eight. Shotgun now for Murray. And he's got the completion to Hopkins. And he is out of bounds inside the 35. Give him 16 yards there, and it's a Cardinals first down as well.
Arizona.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. From the gun, Murray. There goes a deep ball, end zone. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. Andy Isabella was the intended target, and that'll bring up second down.
I like what they did there because many of the deep throws we see in the course of a game come to the outside, the perimeter of the field. In this case, they used a slot receiver to run deep downfield and tried to connect that way. Unsuccessful in that attempt, but I like what they were doing.
Back to the air on second down, it's Murray. And that is incomplete. Down to 15 seconds now. Andy Isabella was the intended target, and it's third down.
He was covered by C.J. Henderson.
This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have him looking at third and 10. Now Murray again going deep for Hopkins. This is caught, and he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. DeAndre Hopkins, as the first half is winding down, and the Cardinals cut into that lead. The Cardinal offense not going anywhere. They'll stay out and go for two. They're going to try and run. And he'll find his way in for two. And we're back to a two-score game. The lead's cut to 16. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away.
Fair catch made at the 25-yard line. The Jaguars take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out.
Now that'll be tipped and intercepted. Jalen Thompson picks it, and his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half.
Take over first and 10 at their own 45-yard line.
So good starting field position for him here as they come up first and 10 at the 45. So that'll back him up five. Delay of game backs him up five, first and 15. A final shot before half for Murray. This one caught by Isabella. And he's out of bounds just before the midfield stripe at the 49.
Out of bounds just short of midfield.
Second and 6. And with just 1 second remaining in the first half, they'll call the timeout. A final shot before break. Murray going deep for Hopkins. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Snags it for the pick. So we've reached halftime here on opening weekend. As we send you a couple hours south of here to Orlando, that's where we check in with a coach and our EA Sports halftime report.
Josh Lambeau to kick off for Jacksonville.
We'll see if week one fatigue becomes any kind of a factor as we are back underway in the second half. Ready to go with their next drive and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. 2 yards the loss, second and 12. At the 23, it's second and 12.
Second and 12. At the 23.
They keep it on the ground. White again. And they work this well upfield across the 45. That one covers 24 yards. It's a first down. You know, I have a pretty good friend, Charles Davis, who tells me that when he sees plays like that, strong runs to the right, reminds him of the 1960s Green Bay Packers.
Boy, those were the days back when the fullback actually carried the ball as well as blocked. Then you had a halfback. He had pulling guards, guys who could get out and run. And you can hear the great coach saying it back then. So we get a seal here. And a seal here, and we run this play right in the alley.
Got out of the pocket. Didn't look like he had anybody open, Charles, so just gets rid of it.
And a good play by him. If no one's open and you don't have a running lane that you want to take, make the right choice. Get rid of it. Live to fight another down.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Check 26. to throw again. Murray. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
When you run in the slant, timing is everything, and against that man coverage, there was no space available, an incompletion as a result.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. To throw, it's Murray. And that's going to be incomplete. The contact there enough to jar that ball free, and it brings up fourth down. So coming up empty here to start the third quarter. Already two scores down. Got to be careful.
Yeah, I did notice, though, that the captain of the defense patted the quarterback on the helmet on his way out, pretty much letting him know, we know the pressure's on us. We're going to go out there and try and hold serve for you while you figure it out over here on the sidelines.
They do go for it. It's Murray. Throwing the out route and complete. That's Richards. And now this is going to be close. The defense says they stopped him, and they did.
Turnover on downs.
They've got good starting field position as they come up here first and 10 at their own 44. Trying to fire up that running game with Dalvin Cook.
Yeah, he'll work free from one tackle, but that's about all as he's taken down.
Tackle made at his.
It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down.
It's now second and six.
They run it again with Cook. And nowhere really to go there. He'll take this up just shy of midfield. Call it a gain of a yard, and it's going to bring up third and five.
A gain of a yard. Brings up third and five.
Hey, check motion man. Put your hands on it. Get hands on motion man. Shut up.
Third down, Dalvin Cook. And they'll get him down about 3 yards short of the first. Just a gain of two there, and it's going to bring up a fourth down.
A 2 yard gain. It's fourth down.
Now movement and a whistle, and they may have to rethink their plans on fourth down. So here we go. The offense is going to stay out there. They're going for it on fourth and eight. They'll try and throw for it here. Connection made with Chenault. And he gets us to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. That's a fourth down pickup of 10 yards and an opportunity certainly missed on the defensive side.
4 yard line.
First down, here's the run with Cook. And he'll be brought down at about the 42. Chandler Jones, a former All-Pro, in on the tackle.
Tough day, tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. Again, it's Cook. 4 yards on the pickup there as it'll leave him with a third and about four more for a first.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time and making it work.
2 yards on the pickup there. It's fourth down.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
This would have been a 54-yard boot had they tried a field goal, but they will not try a field goal. They're going for it. Off the bootleg, Whitfield. The open man is Westbrook. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25. That's a fourth down pickup of 10 yards and an opportunity certainly missed on the defensive side. They'll run on first down. It's Cook. And this time they were ready for him as they'll stop him right at the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Brings up second and 12 at the 28-yard line.
A small bit of adversity here on what's been a strong drive as they come up second and 12. Back to throw. Whitfield. This one caught by Davis.
Whitfield.
Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down.
Well, they were unable to make anything really big out of that, but it's not a bad idea to find your tight end and give him an easy completion and keep moving things forward. Almost as bread and butter as a good running back dive play.
On third down, Whitfield. And he completes it to Westbrook. And he does not get to the first down marker as they stop him at the 19. Just a 5-yard pickup, and it leads to fourth down. On fourth down, Whitfield. That is caught at the 7. And he can't quite get there. Tackled down at the 1. Some collective exhales over there on the sideline. A big pickup through the air on fourth down to bring up first and goal. Back now in Jacksonville. It's Jaguar football here, and they'll look to extend their lead as we begin quarter number 4. A good chance now to put this game on ice. This is first and goal. They'll run with Cook, and he'll take this one in for a Jags touchdown. Dalvin Cook, already his second touchdown here in this opening weekend. And the Jaguars add on to their lead. And that PAT pushes the lead up to 23 now.
That's the score, Jaguars 31, Cardinals 8.
Touchdown. He'll kick this one away. And that one bounces out of the back of the end zone, so we'll start the drive at the 25 on the touchback. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And they knew coming in that this would be a tough place to go in and win a season opener. But this has just been a performance, to be frank, not to be proud of here as they trail big in this fourth quarter. Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone.
It's now second.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. The Jaguars going to go ahead and use their first timeout. That'll leave them with 2 remaining. We'll be back after this. An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Now contact up front as penalty markers come in. Who is this against? So a jump there defensively.
It's a killer. Watch the football. Don't move across the line of scrimmage until the ball moves.
So the penalty certainly helps them out as they come up on second and 5. Operating from the gun, Murray. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. Give him 32 on the play. From the gun, Murray. Now he lets it go deep for Kirk. And my goodness, another interception. Monte Nicholson picks it. And he'll take it all the way up near the 30-yard line. Interception woes, they just continue to mount. He's thrown 5 picks. At this point, you got to be thinking, is it something between the ears?
I think a confidence hit does occur once you start getting those numbers up there a little bit. But as you and I both know, it's not always just one guy's fault. Maybe somebody ran a wrong pattern. Maybe some balls were tipped. It could be so many different things. Bottom line, though, it comes back to the guy throwing them.
Big yardage after the catch. That one winds up going for 36. How about the rookie in his NFL debut? Looking sharp. It's first and 10. And the pressure will bring him down here. The Cardinals get home for the sack.
Down and sack.
Gotta imagine the pass rush will be equally intense here on second down following the sack. It's second and 18. Under pressure again, and down he goes again.
Okay, let's go back a little bit and see if my schooling comes to the front. What's that old saying? Those who forget the lessons of history are doomed to repeat them. That's the same guy who's gotten back-to-back sacks. I think a double team may be in order.
Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. Looking long for Westbrook. And that is intercepted on the sideline. Wait, no. They'll say no. It was caught out of bounds. So this is just an incompletion here. And with things looking pretty good on the scoreboard, they're going to keep the offense out there and go for it here on fourth. Now they go for it on fourth, but this one is going to wind up incomplete. The Jags come up empty on fourth down. And this defense will take over right at midfield. Murray and the Cardinals with a first and 10 right at the 50-yard line. This one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46. Not what they had in mind there. That's going to go as a loss of four. Throwing on second and 14. Murray. And this will be incomplete. Another pass attempt, another incompletion, and they're just a little over 100 yards passing here in this game. So defensively, pretty good job.
Definitely, because they were never really able to get the ball in the hands of their playmakers. So a lot of credit to the defensive game plan and especially the execution.
Throwing on third and long, Murray. And tight coverage there. It's knocked away, incomplete.
How about some applause for the defense there? They forced him to throw that one into coverage, and just like that, they're staring at a fourth down. Well done.
Murray and company going for it on fourth. Flush to his right. Hit as he throws, and this is going to be incomplete. The Cardinals unable to convert there on fourth down. And the Jags take over in terrific field position. Another tote for the workhorse this afternoon. It's Cook. Pass, and he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. Touchdown, Jaguars. Dalvin Cook with now three week one touchdowns. And the Jaguars are pouring it on.
I guess when you look back on it, it was just a matter of time until he popped a big one like that. And, you know, at halftime, you and I discussed it. They had done a nice job on him in the first half. But there were a couple of occasions where it felt like he might wiggle out of traffic and take it to the house. Finally here in the second half, that got done.
On the return, Isabella. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line.
The Cardinals take over first and 10 at their own 17-yard line.
Ready to go with their next drive and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complementary football? Offense take care of the defense, defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down.
So if we recount real quick, he had the touchdown earlier, and now he comes up with the sack here. No doubt about it, he's having himself a game.
Well, that last sack puts Murray and the Cards in a tough spot, third and long. Now Murray. And now here is another interception. Picked up by Josh Jones. And they will score. It's a Jacksonville touchdown. That's the story of the game. They've been suffocating all game long on defense. They were suffocating there again in a big way.
And they've done it not just by out-athleting them, which is often the case, but by being able to adjust to anything they tried to throw at them and beating them to the punch each and every time. This was a defense that was well-prepared.
On the return, Isabella. And he'll be tackled just shy of the 25.
Isabella on the return. The Cardinals take over first and 10 at their own 24-yard line.
Ready to go with their next drive and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And you can sort of sense their dejection. That last pick six put the icing on the cake, so to speak, in what has been a rough go for them. And this will go as a gain of 7 as he gets it to the 30-yard line.
A 7-yard pickup.
They stay on the ground with White. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Now a carry for White. And we are inside of 2 minutes left in this lopsided affair. So the Cardinals, they've got the football here as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. From the 38, Murray sliding out of the pocket. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield. Complete. And all the way down to the 10-yard line. A big play there on the catch and run. 53 yards. And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
That incompletion is not a surprise with the way that this one has gone, and the frustration, the body language is evident everywhere. This team, they've really been put through the ringer in this one.
Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Normally you think the tight end's going to be able to catch the football and handle that contact, but in this case, maybe a little too much target to hit. That one was timed well, incomplete.
Murray now, third and goal. And somewhat of a measure of revenge as he's in for the touchdown, but they still trail big time.
He'll take it, but he won't be able to smile about it. Well, I do have one word for that touchdown for you, partner. You ready?
Yeah.
Cosmetics.
Just makes things look a little better. I don't know. It's like putting lipstick on a pig.
Yeah, and it's hard to do, too. And the pig doesn't like the lipstick a heck of a lot, but you do like the fact that they're battling down the stretch, still trying to put something on the board, even though this game is over.
By the way, how rude is that to the pig? Look at all the things they give us. Pulled pork, bacon. Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line.
25-yard line.
The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. And this game comfortably in hand. The scoreboard speaks for itself, but you still got your starting quarterback out there. When do you go to the backup, Lincoln? The Cards get to him here. He's brought down for a sack. Now the Jags will use the second of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. And they need to work to at least get some of this yardage back after the sack. Second and 19. Keeps himself upright. That's a strong. And he's going to be brought down. Back at his own 6-yard line. A
Hassan Reddick in there to drop him at sacks on first and second downs. Now leads to a third and long. The Cardinals going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 55 seconds remaining in the football game. Throwing on third and long, Whitfield. And that will be incomplete.
That's an excellent job right there on third down. Like any defense, you never want to let them get anything started. And that would have been a first down. Instead, you saw the contact on time, no penalty. And before this drive could get wings, it's fourth down.
That's pulled in at the 32. And when it's said and done, it's a 58-yard punt. And the Cards will take over first and 10.
36-yard line.
Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. They're down big here late. I don't know. You just one last drive here for pride?
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once. We were down huge, and someone said, "Coach, what do you want to call?" He just waved a hand like, "Who cares? Let's get out of here and do something some other time." But some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better as they continue to move forward.
Yeah, probably just want to put this one behind them. They'll try again from the 36 on second and 10. Forced out to his left. And a big loss here as he's taken down.
We've been around this league for a while, and many coaches never pull their starting quarterback, almost no matter the situation. In this case, though, I think he's got to make a decision. He's taking a pretty good beating out there.
Yeah, and with the deficit, maybe not wanting to risk an injury. Well, that last sack puts Murray and the Cards in a tough spot, third and long. From the gun, Murray eluding the pressure right. And that one drops incomplete as he got popped as he was throwing it. What we just saw there, that's really been a common theme all afternoon.
A lot of pressure. That forced the errant pass. He's been under duress this entire afternoon. He just had to unload that one. He's fortunate it was just incomplete and not intercepted.
Boy, not deterred from those first two failed attempts. They're going to go a third time here on fourth down. They're going for it. It's Murray. And this is going to be incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And boy, possession here turns over with the football already being in the red zone. So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. Now it looks like he'll throw here to the end zone, but it's incomplete. DJ Chark, the intended target, and now it's second down.
When you look at the scoreboard, you'd think they'd be pretty comfortable right now with this lead, but these guys are absolutely not going to let up. They want to increase their lead, and they want to do it with a big play. Unable to connect in that attempt.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Off the bootleg, Whitfield. They're trying to find Chark, but it's intercepted. Picked off by Byron Murphy. And a very good return as he takes us all the way up to the 35-yard line.
The Cardinals. They'll take over first and 10 at their own 35-yard line.
Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. This is just an exercise in futility. Do you even bother running a play here offensively?
I wouldn't, because now is not going to erase what's happened during the game. So after it's over, you're going to go to the film, find out where the game was really lost. But this is not a situation now where you're going to make up for anything.
We'll see what they do here. One final try. Jaguar pressure and a Jaguar sack.
Today is
a big offense
offensive explosion help leading them to victory. And the defensive guys, they're just saying, hey, put those points up every week. We'll just keep winning.
They will gratefully accept them, won't they? It makes their job that much easier when they're scoring that many points, allows them to play with a